Politics can be brutal, and the new coalition government's been left battered and bruised after an embarrassing gaffe on the first day of Parliament sitting.
Chaotic scenes erupted in the House as the coalition was forced to make concessions to National after being confused about the numbers. And National's already warning it's a taste of things to come, with it being the biggest opposition party we've ever had. Political reporter Katie Bradford explains.
Unprecedented and dramatic scenes in Parliament. As the government nearly falls at its first hurdle, electing a Speaker.
I nominate Honourable Trevor Mallard as Speaker of the House.
The government had five MPs missing. So National called its bluff and threatened to force a vote that could have seen Labour's pick, Trevor Mallard, lose and leave the government red-faced. That left those in charge scurrying back and forth across the House, trying to find a solution. Eventually, Labour agreed to National's demands to increase the number of MPs on select committees.
So it was unprecedented. I've never seen that happen on the day of electing a Speaker.
New Zealanders are entitled to expect better from the House than that. Ultimately, that was not a situation of our choosing. That was the opposition decided, once the vote was about to start, that they weren't committed to the original understanding.
To make matters worse, Labour actually had the numbers and would have won if National had forced a vote.
I think it was more importantly a show of the disorganisation on the government side. They've got three parties, they didn't know their own numbers. Every day they're going to have challenges.
We had the numbers. What you saw today was sadly a bit of politics.
But what this was a real show of power from National. Confident after 9 years in government that it has the upper hand when it comes to strategy, and a sign of things to come that it won't take opposition lying down. Away from the rough and tumble of the House was the pomp and ceremony of the 52nd Parliament being opened. And eventually Trevor Mallard was elected Speaker.
I want to start off by thanking members for the somewhat delayed confidence they've shown in me.
Your cycling experience will help you, I'm sure, as Speaker. You know how to keep the pace high, how to use the brakes sparingly, and how to never backpedal.
You would certainly be in the top 10 greatest hits of... parliamentary performers in a whole lot of different ways.
But no doubt Speaker Mallard's going to have a tough job keeping this House under control. Katie Bradford, One News.
And One News political editor Corin Dan's been watching developments and joins us now. First day of Parliament, rough day for the government, Corin.
Yes, it was. They were putting on a brave face tonight, but I think the pictures said it all. This was a messy, confusing look for the first day of Parliament for this new government, and I think that's particularly worrying for them, given that, of course, it is a government with those three different components. Look, no damage really done in the end. This was a bloody nose that the government got from the opposition here, and the opposition flexing its muscles a little bit. The government got the Speaker it wanted without that vote. So in the end, there was no damage done. But I think it, certainly signals that this is going to be a tough ride ahead for the government, and they'll want to have a much better day tomorrow.
One face missing there today. Winston Peters not in Parliament, but still certainly making his presence felt.
He most certainly is. An extraordinary move by the Deputy Prime Minister today, serving legal papers on nine people, including former Cabinet Ministers, the likes of Bill English, Stephen Joyce, also some National Party staffers and two journalists over that alleged leak of his superannuation overpayment details, if you remember that from during the election campaign. He is still obviously clearly feels that that was a privacy breach, and he is searching for information over that. Now, one of those journalists who has been served those papers, Tim Murphy from Newsroom, he's described this in a post on his website as a fishing expedition, and I guess some of those will be feeling the same way. But clearly a bold move by Winston Peters on the first day of Parliament, the Deputy Prime Minister, particularly serving papers against two journalists.